Dating apps are a lot like voting. If they mattered, you wouldn't be allowed to do it. Hey guys, welcome back to the Dumbcat channel. Yeah, according to IFL Science, half of the users on the dating websites had no real intention of meeting anyone. And that doesn't really surprise me at all, because people talk about how, oh, online dating, that's how people meet one another now. Like it's really replacing work and school and college and churches and all these other. I'm not endorsing all of these institutions. I'm not saying you should go to work and look for your wife or whatever, but when you look at what was going on in the workforce in the last several decades, for a while, yeah, people did find their wives at college. They did find their wives at high school. A lot of times they did find their wives or husband at work, but since that's been systematically shut down, you got the Me Too shutting down all that stuff at work, so you can't find a spouse at work. That, because that whole environment of, oh, if you try to ask my L, it might be used against you. You also have the situation at school where men aren't even going to college anymore. School, people are pretty much brainwashed to basically prioritize social media over building any real relationships with people. So, yeah, so you can't get married when you're too young. No, you got to have fun. Basically, you got to play the field. I mean, that's what people are programmed. That's what people are encouraged to do. I just saw this really fascinating article. Well, it's just an interesting topic. I mean, what do you guys think? Do you think social media, do you think dating apps are really contributing to people finding what they're really looking for? Because I think a lot of these dating apps are just serving as a platform for women to get attention. You know, it just gasses them up. It just boosts people's egos. And I've spoken with some women. They basically say that, oh, I get thousands of likes or whatever, or on social media, whatever. They get this attention and they feel better about themselves, but they don't have any real results. Any results really matter. Like, you can have 10,000 likes on your social media, but that's, you're getting superficial attention. You're not getting attention that really matters. You know, you're not getting a husband, somebody who's willing to fight and die for you if it's necessary. That type of attention, you're getting superficial, meaningless attention. Like, oh yeah, thumbs up. I mean, I like beautiful women as much as anybody else, but people need to think about the quality of the attention, not just the volume of attention they're actually getting. So just want to throw that out there. All right. This is a really interesting article in the Daily Mail. It's called, I checked my husband's phone and found messages of him calling me ugly, quote, ugly, when we first got together. Now I'm questioning everything. So Jan from New Jersey, it went on her husband's phone with this permission, and she found old text messages of him talking to his friend, talking about how she was basically really interested in him. I would just put it that way. And how he had dated women who were more attractive, but he also refers to those women as being stuck up. And now her confidence is shaken, and we're reading about this. And I'm thinking, okay, it's interesting because he mentioned other women being more attractive, but he didn't marry those other women. He didn't really stick with those other women. He called them stuck up. So, you know, you can meet people who are physically attractive, but you can realize that, okay, these people don't have any characteristics beyond their physical appearance. That doesn't mean they're actually wife material. And at some point, he thought that she was wife material. Sometimes you meet people and you're not that physically attracted to the person, but you see other qualities. Maybe the woman can cook. Maybe the woman is supportive. Maybe she's got your back. You know, like he said, that she's willing to do anything for me. I hope he didn't exploit that and use that. But, you know, it's, she said, quote, I have ugly duckling syndrome. I always think I'm really bad looking. I would have left him if I found these messages in the beginning. I have to try to move past it. It's 7 years later and we're married. Well, okay, end quote. Okay. Hey, if you're happy in your marriage, I mean, that's something you need to focus on, because first impressions aren't always something that stick. Sometimes you meet people and you get to know them and you see a different side of them and they become more attractive. I don't know. You guys share your thoughts on this. Thoughts on dating apps. how effective are they in helping people achieve their goals? Maybe men just want to hook up with women. Maybe some of these guys actually want a relationship. Maybe they want a marriage. A lot of these women do want relationships. I look on there and I see the people saying, a lot of women saying that I'm not interested in the hookup, but usually when they say that, well. Anyway, share your thoughts, guys. That's the question of the day. Do you think dating apps are a good replacement for traditional institutions and helping people find relationships that they're looking for, whether it be marriage or long-term commitments, long-term relationships?